My name is Pierre Rivière. I did a PhD at INRA in France in the team of Isabelle Goldranger on participatory breeding on bred wheat. So I did it for 4 years. And then I worked for 5 years at Réseau Semences Paysannes, who is a network of peasant seed in France. And I was in charge of research program and facilitating breeding program on several species. And now, so I quit the network, and with former colleagues, we created a new structure, cooperative, which is part of Réseau Semences Paysannes. And the aim is to develop peasant seeds in southwest of France mainly. So, and today, so I will speak about a work I did on experimental design and statistical tools that we used in our PPB program. And it's a work that we started 10 years ago. So, hop. Hello. Okay. So the objective, there are two objectives. The first one of this presentation, it's present to you that efficient design and statistical methods and tools exist for organic agriculture. And based on all the constraints we can have in a network and on farm. So the main idea is to give you this information. I will not go into the theoretical details, but just to show you a big picture of what we can do. And then, as Fred told, the idea is to discuss how to think network trials organization in organic agriculture, knowing this kind of methodology. So at the beginning, the main point of using of our methodology is to say that in organic agriculture, there are heterogeneous environment and practices. So the idea is to valorize G by E interaction in order to look for the right variety in the right place and to do the evaluation in real condition on farm. So not in research station, which are often in a really luxurious condition with a lot of nitrogen and water and so on, and big soil, deep soil, but to do on farm and in several farms where all the farmers are different in pedoclimatic condition and soil and practices. So the idea is really to look and to find a variety adapted to the farm. And to do this, we use a large network, and this is really a key point in all our methodology. It works because there is this network, and this is really important because it allows to have a high diversity of environment and practices. So, for example, on bred wheat, we had almost 100 farms in our program, which are really different, all in France. There is a high number of varieties because the farmers they can choose all the varieties they want, as I will show you. And also, it gives us statistical robustness. So it's because we have lots of data that we manage to do statistics. And this it works because it is participatory. And this we will speak about it at the end because to make the coordination of this network and to make it work, it works because it is participatory, and this raises lots of organizational issue. Okay, so just the idea. So it's a work that we did in diversity food. So I will show you just some decision trees. So in the middle we have experimental design and statistical method for PPB, and then we have 1, 2, 3, 5 pink circle, which correspond to several objectives that we find in PPB program. So for example, it can be study network of seed circulation to study a network topology of exchange of seeds. It can be study diversity, so mainly about molecular markers. It can be improve prediction of a target variable for selection. So regarding a correlation analysis, and it can be also a comparison of variety in different location. So is this variety different from this one? And it's can be also to study the response of variety under selection over several environments. So the idea to have how behave a variety in several environment and look at the interaction. So this kind of it's a kind of objective that we have, and based on this objective, we can look at agronomic traits, or it can be sensory analysis, or nutritional data, molecular data. So to reach the objective, we can have several type of data that we collect during the program. And for each objective, there are several methods based on different experimental design, and they will be different based on the number of plots per location, the number of location, the number of replicated germplasm within and between location, which is very different. And this, in of course, it's dependent of the amount of seeds available, and with often high disequilibrium in the data. And in our case, it's always high disequilibrium in the data. And here I will not go into details, but this is a decision tree with all the different steps, and you can choose depending on how many location you have, what space do you have, if you can do replication and so on. And at the end, in yellow, you have the right analysis. So I don't go into details, but this is to show you that we work on a decision tree to based on the constraint and the objective to find the right analysis. Okay, and now I will show you concrete examples. So first on the agronomic analysis. So there are several objectives. Here I give just two examples. So the first one is compare different varieties evaluated for selection in different locations. And to reach this objective, we have three methods. So the first one is a classic ANOVA on fully replicated design. There is also spatial analysis on and mixed model based on other designs that I will show you. And we also did we developed a model also based on Bayesian statistic to deal with high disequilibrium in the network. So these three kind of analysis we can have. I will show you one. And then a second objective, for example, study the response of variety under selection over several environments. And there is, for example, AMI and GGE, which is a classical analysis. And also we developed also a Bayesian model that deal with higher disequilibrium, and that we'll show you. So for example, on spatial analysis, so here it's on one farm. So this is interesting if you do, for example, an evaluation 1 year. And on the left, you have the experimental design. So a little square, it corresponds to a plot, for example, 10 square meters. And you have in black the control, and in white any germplasm that you choose. So for example, you have 4 times 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 4 times 7. So you have 28 plots, and on the 28 you have 2, 3, 6, you have 7 controls and lots of variety. So this is interesting because with you maximize the space you have. And when you have this kind of design, then you can run your model, check if it goes well, and get the blobs. So the blob is just an estimation of of your effect, and then you can compare your mean. So this it's one example of on disequilibrium set. And we have another example. So here, based on the Bayesian method that we developed within my PhD, and the idea is to have a network of farm. So this analysis, it works if you have at least 25 farms per year. So you need a high, big network. And then each farm choose which kind of design it wants to do. So if you have a farm with a lot of facilities, then you are a regional farm. So on here on on the left. And in regional farm, you have two blocks, and in each block, four control. So four in the top and four below, and then you choose all the variety you want. And if you have less possibilities, then you have a satellite farm and you have only one control replicated twice in black, and then you choose. So for example, in Unreal Data, some satellite farms has only five varieties, and some regional farm has up to 100. And with 100, we did, for example, four blocks. But it's really it's a, there is a framework, and then each firm can choose based on what they can do if they want to be a regional firm or a satellite firm. And when we sum up all the information, then we run our model, and we get effect. So it's classical effects on the germplasm effect, location effect, and sensitivity to interaction. So it's a classical effect that we get in this kind of analysis, but the original point is that you can get the information with really high disequilibrium data set because we agree on the control in black, and then everyone choose which variety he wants. So it allows to lots of freedom and also lots of information. And here, just to show you, also based on this model, it's always the same to estimate effect. And so, with this effect estimated, we can use it in special regarding special question. And for example, we did it to study response to selection. And the idea is to say, okay, I did a selection last year. So what is the difference between what I did select and the bulk of my population? And do I find the same difference in the next generation? So does my selection work? And so we to do it, we just set side by side the selected version, so what the farmer selected, and just next to it the bulk of the population. So it's a simple way to study response to selection, and we have the information because we use the network and all the information in the network. So this it was quite interesting to study response to selection over all the farm, and it does not add too much work. It's just a way of what do I sow in my on my farm, but it's the same amount of work otherwise. And we can also on the right study local adaptation. So this it's also specific model, but based on the same idea, we can look at local adaptation. So those varieties that I have in my farm for 10 years, is it better than the same varieties that come from another farm? And is the varieties that I cultivate for 5 years on my farm is more adapted than the same varieties that come from another farm? So it's this kind of question, and we can answer this question in always in the in this framework that we did in the network. Okay, and I will give some other examples. So on sensory analysis. So just two examples. The first one is based on hedonic analysis to understand and check consumer preferences. In the other one, it's on mapping analysis to characterize product sensory properties. And in those two cases, it's the same idea. It's simple protocols that we can do easily. So for hedonic analysis, it's just people that taste samples and give a note and a descriptor. So it's really easy. I taste, okay, it's nice, so I put a 9, or oh, it's horrible, I put a 1. And I give descriptors like, oh, it's with a sugar or bitter, or things like that. And then we run the model and we can have a group of samples that are sorted according to the descriptors that we have. And we can also have a mapping analysis. So the idea is that the jurors, they sort and place sample on a paper, and they give descriptor on group of samples. So for example, I put all the breads that are not really good on the left, and all the bread which has a banana taste on the right. and I give information on how I put this group. And then with all the paper of all the jerseys, we run the model, and again we can find group and see how we can describe the different product. And another aspect which can be interesting in this kind of PPB program is to look at network analysis to see how his history of the seeds. And there are two examples and objectives. So the first one, it's a topology of UniProt network when we are looking at seed lots. So seed lot, it's a combination of a germplasm in a given location, a given year, and the link between the seed lot, its relationships such as diffusion, mixture, reproduction, and so on. And also we can look at BPart network to see how location share several germplasm or not. So I give you just one example. So on the left, you have a UniProt network with all the year, so 2005 up to 2009 in this example, in several location. The little in color, the little ball, you have the germplasm, and the arrows represent the relationship. And then you can retrace the, you can have the history of the different seed lot on the left, and on the right, just to see, for example, for location one, which kind of germplasm I have, for location four, etc. And then you can get descriptive data, this kind of network and information to see a bit how behave the different exchange. And what I want to show you now, so I give you a brief overview of the kind of analysis we do during a participatory plant breeding program. And what we did, and we created a software to run easily the analysis. Because we show at the beginning, it's what's nice to have all these methods, but it was only in the research labs. And the idea is to make it available for other person or the organization so that they can run PPB program and run this kind of analysis. And so we are creating a package, which is an R package, which is under development, PPB stat. And so there are four type of data it can handle. So network of seed management, or agronomic trial in order to set, describe, and analyze balance and unbalanced trials, organoleptic test, and molecular experiment. And the objective is to have a single package capable of performing all analysis that we can find within PPB program with a comprehensive documentation that I will show you. And also the idea would be to create a community working on PPB program to exchange how we deal with the data, how we analyze it, how we do with the farmers. And within the software, we have a kind of workflow. So you can see on the left. So you can generate the design experiment. Then you have to format your data for a specific format. And once it's formatted, you can run your model, check it, and do mean comparison. And on each step, you can have a plot to see the output. So this is the general workflow on the left. And on the right, you have an example with some model, or when we have, for example, we format the data, and then we can choose between three models. So the Bayesian model, the classical ANOVA, or spatial analysis, the ones that I showed you just before. And then again, we can check if the model went well, compare mean, and have output with plot. And we did this kind of workflow for each kind of analysis. And an important point is that when you do an analysis, it's good, but you need to give back the information to farmer so that we can have a support to a report to discuss with them to analyze the results. And so also in the package, we have a functionality to make this kind of report. And what we did within my PhD and after, it's that we generated one report for each farm. And so each farm has a personal feedback of what he did. And also, all the farm have a common section in the report with all the information coming from the network, with a general germplasm effect and location effect and so on. But this it can be changed according to the objective that we have. And I will show you just the website just to see you how it works. So here it's the website of the package with some example. And we have so yes, how to download it and to install it. And also there is a book. And you can see in the book, so you have a general aspect on philosophy of PPB, and then on network, agronomic analysis, sensory analysis, and so on. And for example, if we go to this kind of analysis, so here it's the example of a response to selection with example and workflow of how we can use it. And for each part, we have also a part on on all the theoretical aspect of the model and so on. Just to show you in short. And yes, so now it's a bit more than 20 minutes. And the idea is to say is that okay, we have lots of tools and statistical method. We can enhance it. It can be better, but we already have lots of things, and it's easy and flexible, and we have the software under development to run it. But the main task, for me at least, it seems to coordinate the network that can use it. And it's I think the most difficult part. So how to organize a network and agree on control and variables to measures, how to do the measures, organize the data and analyze it. So the main point is to organize it. Once it's organized, then to analyze it's quite quick. And the main important point, I think, it's to give information back and discuss it with the farmer. Because from my experience, sometimes we just send the report. We didn't have time to have a meeting to discuss it, and so it didn't work. But when we have time to discuss it with the farmers, then it works, and they can profit from all the information. So I guess there is a new social technical organizational model to create, several models to create. Okay, that's it.